It's February, it's the love month, and I was going to ask you about stocks to love this February. And you mentioned it already, BDO Securities, you guys like tourism, the tourism play. You think it's going to sustain growth after recovery. You're banking on improving infrastructure to support sector expansion. Which names in particular in the tourism sector are you liking? I'm looking at your report, and a few of them actually stand out. You have Bloomberry, Cebu Air, and Macro Asia. What's so special about the three?
Well, Cebu Air and Macro Asia are key players in the tourism industry. Mm-hmm. Cebu is the largest airline in the country and has a very well-respected brand. So it will be an immediate beneficiary for both international and domestic tourism. Actually, you can already see that in Cebu Pacific's numbers. Macro Asia is a provider of services to airlines. So as the airlines go, so does Macro Asia. Bloomberry is also going to be a direct beneficiary of the uptick in tourism. It's a market, one of the market leaders in the integrated resort industry in the Philippines and generates a lot of interest from both regional and international visitors to the country.
Mm-hmm. And let's not forget, Bloomberry, Enrique Razon is about to open his new casino this year in Vertis North, a new Solaire casino rising at the Vertis North. Plus, yesterday we did report, Gabby, the BMI, a Fitch Solutions unit, saying that they think foreign tourist arrivals will fully recover to pre-pandemic levels within 2024. Zooming out of, you know, going beyond the tourism play, I wonder, when you look at trading activity in BDO Securities, whether it's online or broker-assisted, what's the sense that you're getting from investors today? Are they sharing this optimism that you have? Or are they more careful, still cautious, still waiting on the sidelines?
There's a note of optimism, but they remain cautious. Some of the investors in the market got stuck with shares that were still priced high when they bought them. So they're still holding on to this. But generally, there's a lot of improved interest in the market. We see that people are watching. You mentioned the run-up of the local market last month, and that generated a lot of attention. People were able to get into the market. Those who generated sufficient returns were able to cash in. So expect that momentum to further improve as we go along, especially as the economic numbers show positive results.
How big of an improvement are you expecting? I mean, we finished down last year, negative returns for those who invested in the stock market in general, if you base it on the PSEI. 4 years of a negative performance, what are you looking at for 2024? Do you have an index call for year end or maybe a target number for yields from the PSEI?
Well, assuming things remain where they are today in terms of trajectory, our base case forecast for the index is 7,000 at the end of the year. That assumes corporate earnings growth of 9%. Now, the bull scenario is an index at 7,600. That assumes that the effects of El Nino are much more tempered than expected, and geopolitical events become more benign. Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid to ask, what is your bear case?
Well,
another down year.
Well, the downside risks are largely beyond our control. Mm. People are watching the developments in the Middle East with concern. the fear of escalation remains. Another major event that people are watching is the invasion of Ukraine. Those are very unpredictable situations, largely beyond the control of a country, especially in our region. But we're hoping that things will work out. There are signs that the parties involved, for instance, in the Middle East, are making a lot of effort to try to de-escalate things.
All right. Gabby, we're 5 minutes into trade for the day. I just wanted to bring in the opening numbers. 5 minutes into trade, and the index is on the up, joining most Asian peers higher. The index is up by 0.5%, 36 points. We're at 66.59. All sub-indices are in the positive, except for one, the property sector, which is down by 0.4%. Just final question, Gabby, before we get to your blind item. I wonder, when you look ahead to 2024, in the next 11 months, what makes you most excited about this market? You know, what gives you that ticklish feeling, that excited feeling about the local market? Is it IPO pipeline? Because the PSE just cleared the very first IPO for this year, C-REC. Is it something else? Is it what? What could it be? Or do you expect it to be boring?
On the contrary, I expect this to be a very exciting year. Putting on my hat as the corporate finance head of Video Capital, I see a very healthy pipeline of capital market transactions, both in the equity and debt capital markets. As you know, it takes a bit of time to prepare for IPOs, and we've been deep in preparation for a couple of these, and several debt capital market transactions. So there's a lot of activity in the debt capital markets. And once these securities are issued, it will provide more choices for capital market investors. So we have a very positive view of the capital markets.
Looks like the year of the dragon is going to be a good year for the stock market. Gabby, I think we're now ready for your blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely and that you like. Don't tell us. Just describe and leave our viewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
Well, this stock is a conglomerate. It has a market capitalization of around 150 billion pesos. It's invested in companies which have leadership positions in the financial services industry, real estate, infrastructure. It's a very well-respected name. And although it's, as you see from the chart, it's run up pretty significantly over the last year. We think that there's still a lot of steam left. Its price-earnings ratio, based on estimated 2024 earnings, is less than 5 times compared to the PSE's around 11.4 times. So you think there's still a lot of value that can be extracted from this stock?
All right, we're just gonna have to guess which stock this is. Gabby, thank you so much. It was nice to meet you. I hope this is the first of many more interviews to come. We'll see you soon.
Thank you for having me, Mimi.